Hi everyone, welcome to another Cosplay tutorial. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up Cosplay for an automated silage production. We're going to need a forage harvester, and we're going to need at least one tractor with a trailer attached to it that can drive the chaff away from the forage harvester. For today, we'll be working on field number 18 on Sosnovka, and right there over on the other side of the road, we have the BGA where we'll be unloading the chaff. At the BGA, I have a tractor waiting that is going to be used for leveling compacting, and we're going to set up Cosplay for that as well. So let's start out by jumping into the forage harvester and set up a course for this one. So we right click to open the Cosplay HUD. Here we go. And we want to be in the field work mode, which is this button here. And we go into the course generation. In here we're going to select the field number 18. And we can verify that it's field number 18 just by clicking this eyeball here. Now we get a blue line all around the field showing us this is the field that we've selected, so let's click that away again. The working width of this machinery is 5.7 meters. Let's just see if that actually adds up. We can use this button here to automate that. It seems like it's adding up with this one here, so that seems just about fine. Now I always like to have a little bit of overlap on these courses, just in case the worker misses something. So let's put that down to 5.2 meters. So we have half a meter of overlap. The starting corner, we're going to be starting in this corner up here, which is this corner there, and that is the furthest most north corner and the furthest most western corner. So northwest is where we're going to start. We have that there, and we're going to be heading in the southern direction. So let's head south with this one here. There we go. Return to first point. We don't really need it, but let's just put it on anyway. That means that when he's done with cutting all of the maize, he's going to return back to this point here, so where he started, or where he started the course. Now for this one, this course here, we will be using headlands. Simply because we're going to set up Cosplay for driving this tractor as well, or these two tractors here. And these two tractors do need quite a bit of space around the field to follow along the forage harvester. So I find it best to set up headlands when you do this. I'm going to use three headlands here, which basically means that the forage harvester is going to go around on the outer side of the field, still in within the field, but the outer side of the field three times before it starts heading up and down, which this icon here indicates. Now this icon here tells it that it starts out with the headlands and it's going anti-clockwise direction. I can click this icon there and it will go clockwise direction. I want it to go anti-clockwise and I want it to continue on to going north and south, which this icon here indicates, when it's done with the headlands. I could choose the other way around, where I start going up and down and then take the headlands afterwards, but it would make more sense to start out with the headlands. There we go. And three times around the headlands before it starts going north and south. So that should be it for this course here. Let's click this button here, which is the course generation button, or generate field course. And we can see just about right here, we have the course set up. Let's start up the engine and drive over to it. Now I want to demonstrate something to you guys here. If you have a close look, you can see that this tractor or this machinery does have the crop destruction mod enabled. I've enabled the crop destruction mod again. And basically if I drive into a field now, you will see here, it will destroy the crop. But there's been an update to Cosplay. So from version, let's have a look. From version 5.01.00109, they have implemented that Cosplay workers will no longer enable the crop destruction mod. Just an FYI. So you can actually have the crop destruction mod enabled and use Cosplay without having any grudges about that. Your crops will not be destroyed, and I'm going to show you that in a little while here. So what you can see here is we have the starting point and the ending point of the course right here. You can also see that he doesn't start within the corner. He actually starts from right here, and then drive him that way there, and then he's going to turn around and do the corner. That is because we've set him to do the headlands first, so he needs to start out there. That's okay. Gonna drive a little bit back. Here we go. And that should give him enough time to settle in on the course when I click drive. But I seem to be just about happy with the course. If I want to double check the course, I can do like that and click that one there. And you can see that I have a full overview of how his course is going to go. I can also, if I wanted to, click this one there, and I would have the same overview in this one here. And you can tell that he's going to start out from there and go in that way there. So let's click those two away again. But I'm happy with the course, so let's save this course as Farage Harvest. Oh wait, hang on. Should probably call it Field 18 Farage Harvest. What's it? Is it 5 meters? I can't remember now. No, it was 7 point. Ah, oh, never mind. Farage Harvest. Let's do it for that. Let's do it like this for this time here. I'm gonna make a new folder for field number 18 because we haven't done any work on this field before. So, gonna make a new folder called Field 18. Here we go. And I'm gonna move this course into the Field 18 container, which we have there. So he's ready to go. I'm gonna go over to this button here and select start course at the first waypoint and drive course. And you will see now I'm not driving the Farage Harvester anymore. And notice how he doesn't actually destroy any crop, which is absolutely brilliant. So now he's set up for cutting this maze. Let's head over and set up a course for a tractor over here. So the tractor I'm gonna set up to automatically drive to the bunker that I'm gonna unload into. And when it's done unloading into that, it's gonna return to the field, head on back to the Farage Harvester, and follow that along. So let's set up a course for this one. Now I wanna start out my course around here somewhere. Let's just have a look. I think here would be fine. So we want to be in the combi mode, the empty combine and offload mode. Let's start the course recording, and again, we want to have 3 waypoints in a relatively straight line before you make any sudden turns. And now you can just drive along. So I'm sticking to the side of the road, so if I needed to, I could have multiple course play courses running at the same time. If I always remember to stick to the side of the road. Now, I'm pulling onto a road here with AI traffic, so I am going to slow down a little bit to give the course player a chance to recognize that there is traffic there. And I want to unload into the first bunker. I'm going to show you a couple of ways of doing this. For this course here, I'm just going to go straight through the bunker. Not going to set a waypoint or anything. Course play will detect that this is an unload point and automatically unload the trailer for us. So I'm going to go back here again. It's an AI traffic road. So I'm going to give Courseplay a little bit of a chance to detect if there's traffic before I head over the road. Back to field 18. And once we're back here, we're going to stop the course. Let's just see just around here. It doesn't matter if you stop the course away from the start point. Actually, this is a good idea so you don't have the tractors crossing over each other's path. So let's stop here. And we want to set it up to, seeing as we've actually started the course outside of the field and we ended the course outside of the field as well, we need to manually set up the find combi mode. So we click this one here and we have the select manually. So it's not the actual flow, it's the RSM 1403, which is 123 meters away from us. So that's the one that we want to use for this one. Had we made the course inside the field, we wouldn't have to do this. We wouldn't have to select manually which combine we wanted to drive to. But it's always a good idea just in case. So there we go. We seem to be just fine for this one here. So let's save this course, and I'm going to call it Field 18. And I'm going to call it Transport There we go, 2BGA. And it was silo 1, and I'm entering from the north. And I'm driving through, so drive through. Oh, I can't even do that. Let's go a little bit back here. Field 18, there we go. Field 18, transport BG, oops, BGA, silo 1. I'm entering from the north and I'm driving through the bunker. When you make these courses, do try to come up with a naming system that makes sense to you. For this here actually makes sense to me. So I know that I'm driving from field 18. It's a transport route or transport course. I'm going to the BGA. I'm entering silo number 1 from the north and I'm driving through the silo. So enter to save this course, and this tractor is set up for that. So all I need to do now is start out this tractor. I'm going to start in from the nearest course. So this is a little handy tip for you. If you start out from the nearest course here, he's not going to go back to start and start driving the course all the way. He's going to go to the stop sign up here, and then he's going to scan for the harvester, which is over here. So let's set him on this course here. There we go. And there we go. He's already detected the combine. And notice how he's not destroying the crops here. Everything is going perfectly. So far, at least. So let's just follow him along here and watch how this actually happens. So again, if you're unhappy with the speed that he's doing, you can go into this button here, which is the speed limits. It has sort of an icon as a speedometer. And you can edit the speed that he's doing. You can either do that by scrolling your mouse wheel, or you can click these buttons out here. But right now he's doing just fine. He's getting a full trailer from the forage harvester that is just working along here. So everything seems to be going fine. I'm going to speed up time and we're going to join him back when he's on the transport route. Alright, so he has a full load now and is just returning to start up the transport route or the transport course. He's going to pick that up here and he's going to head back to the BGA. So let's have a look at how he does that. Again, he's going to follow the route or the course that I set up, and he's going to try to drive at the same speed that I set the course up in as well. So he's going to slow down once he comes down to the road down here. There we go. And now he's going to enter the silo 1. I just called it silo 1. It seems like a logical thing for me. He detects the tip trigger and he's going to unload here. There we go. Now this is working out perfectly. See how well he places the chaff all over the silo, or in a straight line in the silo? It's not like a big hump or something. He's very good at spreading it out. And now he's going to return to the stop point of the transport course, and he's going to pick up where he left off with the forage harvester. There we go. No combine in reach. And now he's going to detect it. There we go. Drive behind combine, and he's off to get another load. So let's just follow him here. See, he drives on behind the combine now. And as he's in vicinity of the combine, he's going to go out to position himself on the side of it. There we go. And they're off. So that's how that works. So let's head back to the BGA. Okay, so at the BGA we have this tractor standing with a leveler attached to it. Now we want to make this tractor go back and forward on the shaft in the silo to compact it. And to do that, we need to set up a course for that. We want to have CoursePlay do it all for us. So let's start up the engine and let's raise the level a little bit. And let's go back into the silo. We want to position ourselves inside the silo when we start the course recording. And we want to be somewhat in the middle of the silo regarding the side of it. So it seems just about there. So for leveling and compacting, you open your CoursePlay HUD and you click the right mouse button and open the CoursePlay HUD. And you want to be in the leveling and compacting mode, which is this one here. Now here you can record the course. Now first of all, we're going to set up a couple of settings for this. So we want to be in the filling up mode, which is this one here. That makes this tractor raise its blade and just drive back and forward on the chaff without leveling in it. It's just driving back and forward. We're also telling the tractor to automatically stop for any vehicle with running engine. I could set it to just stop for CoursePlay engines, but we're going to set it for all engines. And it's detecting tractors in the range of 50 meters. I've tested this thoroughly, and for this tractor to detect a tractor coming in at this end, when it's all the way in this end, the minimum you want is 40 meters here. I tend to leave it at 50 meters because that seems to be working the best. The width of this blade is just about 5 meters, or at least that's where I get the best result. And the max speed while pushing is 20 kilometers. All right, that seems just about fine. So we're ready to record the course. So we go into the CoursePlay control button, which is this one there. Start the course recording. And again, you want to start this course inside the silo and just hit forward, straight forward. And you can position yourself up here. So this is where you tell the tractor to go up here when a tractor is approaching the silo to unload the chaff. So you want this tractor to get out of the way so the transport tractor, which is actually approaching right now, so this transport tractor can come in here and go into the silo without crashing into this one here. So we set a wait point here and tell the tractor this is where you're going to go when you have to wait. Now the wait point of this silo, you want to have that within the side of the silos. You want to be within these two sides of the silo for it to work best. Now do remember, the CoursePlay is a development version right now, and there can be bugs, and there is bugs. One of the bugs that I've discovered is that you can't be 100% certain of the result if you put the wait point outside of the side of the bung, the silo. So if I were to put my wait point over here, for instance, I could do that and the tractor will be able to find its course and go back into the silo. But I've just had some really weird results. So I find it best to put the wait point within the side of the silos. And now we can go back. So I press the reverse button, which is this one here. So we're going to tell this tractor to go back into the silo. Now, for these particular silos, I want to stop just about here. That seems about right. Because what's going to happen now is, when I tell this tractor to drive this course, it's going to lower the blade to see how high above the ground is this blade. And if you notice here, there's a little slope going into the silo. So I want the compact tractor to recognize the height of the ground here, where it's level. So I set the stop sign here. And there we go. We are actually done with this course, so let's have a look if it works. So I'm just going to drive the course. There we go. Now you'll find that he does this. He tends to be on the one side of the silo at all times, or she. But she's just going to go back and forward until a tractor approaches. Now I'm going to speed her up a little bit. I don't want the reversing speed to be 6 kilometers. So we're going to set that to 15 kilometers. And she seems to be doing just fine now. She's going to go to the stop point, which is there. Lower the blade to see how high it is above the ground. And then she's continuing on. Now, the working width I set to 5 meters, and as you can tell, the blade is just avoiding the side of the silo. I find the best result with this is the small blade, by the way. I find the best result with this is 5 meters of working width. So you can toy around with it and see whatever suits you the best. But she's gonna go on like this now, and if we put on this one here, can we actually see how? No, we can't. We can if we go out here. So we can tell that the silo is 100% compacted now, so we could go ahead and blanket it if we wanted to. But obviously we have an entire field of chaff that we wanna silage, so it's gonna be a while before we blanket this silo. But now we set up 100% automated system, but as you can tell, this tractor here will stick to the left side for some odd reason. It will stick to the left side of the bunker. Doesn't matter how full the bunker is, it will stick to the left side. So that's one of the issues as well that I've discovered. But it works really well, and now let's watch it here as the transport tractor is coming and see how this goes. So when this tractor here detects the transport tractor, wow, that was difficult for me to say, you can tell that the beacons are turned on and the transport tractor has stopped over there waiting for permission to go into the silo again. So as soon as the compact tractor is done compacting, it's going to go to the wait point that we set up by the tree up there. And when it's out of reach or out of the way, the transport tractor will continue its course. Now notice how it stops the engine. It does that after 30 seconds. You can change that, by the way. And there we go. The transport tractor goes into the silo and unloads in here. And it's really as simple as that, guys. So this works perfectly. Now you really want to be in the filling up mode in here on this tractor when you do this. If you have a tractor, a transport course going through the silo, going all the way through the silo, you definitely want to be in the filling up mode. Otherwise, well, I'm going to show you that in a little while. I'm just going to let this one go a little bit and I'm going to show you the result after a little while. First of all, let's save this course, and we're going to save this as, let's save it as BTA compact silo 1 drive through, north drive through. So now I know this course is for the BTA, and it's compacting in silo number 1. And it's entering from the north and it's driving through. So I'm going to return and save that course. Oh, I forgot to put this one into the field 18 container. Let's do that into the field 18 container. I'm going to make a new container here called BGA. And I'm going to put this one in. Oops. I didn't mean to do that. I'm going to put this one into the BGA. There we go. So I can set up a course for each silo in here if I wanted to. I could do that even if the silo is empty. I'm not going to do that right now, but I am going to show you how to do a different style of this. Which there's a different version of doing this as well, where you don't have a tractor driving through the silo. Let's say that you have a silo that is only accessible from one end. You want the tractor, the transport tractor, it can't possibly go through the silo, so you want it to reverse into the silo and unload. I'm going to be showing you that in a little while. I'm going to let this run and for a little while and fill up this silo quite well so you guys can see how that goes and see the result of this, because you will see that it will only fill up one side of the silo. Right, I'll be back in a little while, guys.